1,000 feet, respecting ILS 110 Miami.
Okay, so now I'm just going to turn you to this heading to give you time to brief the coach. I want you to brief it perfect.
Yeah.
And fly the airplane at the same time.
This has like an anti-trim, right?
Yep.
So, Miami, Florida, Kelvis, temperature 13 to 6th of February 2014, it's valid. ILS are localized when we're at a right, Miami, Kendall, Time, Miami City, direct code. Localizer, 108.7.
Before we do that, what else are we supposed to do first? What's the first thing?
The ATIS. Listen to the ATIS.
Exactly. Because why are you going to waste your time, you know, briefing an approach when you find out that the winds are favorable to runway 27 and they're not going to let you do opposite traffic approach?
Yeah.
So, there you go. So you have information alpha, wind is from 090 at 10, altimeter is 2993.
Information alpha?
Information alpha. So, now you know you can shoot the approach, right? Now brief the approach.
I didn't get the altimeter.
2993.
Course, you're
when you say it, I would like you to do it.
Yeah, but it was scarce.
Do it. It's not active. Because we don't need the UR anymore.
Approach course, 093. Score 093, runway length 6,000 feet. Airport elevation is 10 feet. Alright,
okay, you have 111 turn south for me, please. 182.
Okay, you have 111 turn ahead of 182. Standard terminal. That's right.
Which one?
For the T.
Non-standard takeoff minutes.
Do we need that? And the alternate ripple, we don't need that.
There's not the alternate.
So, okay. We have a Mauser lighting system.
Okay. 180 on the head.
Yeah, we just have hiding the. This approach, climb to 2,000 feet, then left turn, we head 088. And both of you are radio 130 to Lovely International. At 14.1 DME and hold. AT's 124.0 already listened to me. Miami approach 125.5.
Catch up.
Miami Tower 118.9. Control 121.7.
You don't have to worry about that.
Yeah. And things, we don't need that either.
Alright, so
right.
Tell me what I'm gonna shoot out for.
Alright, we're gonna. Our initial approach fix will be. Then fly heading 273, fly heading altitude 2,500 feet.
Okay. If we're doing a full approach, right?
We're doing a full approach.
What is 273. Why 273?
Because we're going to, we're not doing the full approach.
No, but when would be online this week?
How would the approach? Once I get to Leyden, I descend to 2,000 feet.
Okay.
Once I get to 2,000 feet, I fly here in 0903.
Okay.
And descend to 1,500 feet,
okay,
which is my final approach fix. Which is when I intercept the light slope.
Very good.
And then.
So, what is.
I start my descent to 210 feet and I need to have mild visibility.
Very good. When do we go missed?
I go missed if we go 4.5 nautical miles and we don't see runway or we get to 210 feet. And we don't see runway.
Okay, area 411.
I'm missing something, right? In the list.
Yeah, there's one thing.
The
how are we gonna identify Leyden if we lose our glide slope? How do I know that we are at the
radial 229 from Dolphin VOR? So where's my radio? Okay, I have two GPSs.
True.
Julie.
No, let's do the VOR check. Area 111, fly heading 150 for me, please.
Well, area 111, fly heading 150.
upon 11, fly heading 120 vectors for ILS approach.
80 upon 11, fly heading 120 respective vectors for ILS approach, runway 9 right, KTM.
And 80 upon 11, verify you have information alpha.
80 upon 11, sorry about that, I got information alpha.
80 upon 11, roger. I'm giving you all the scenarios that happen to me.
Yeah.
They want to verify that you have the information. Alright, so now you're getting vectors. And they're going to ask you to move on. Okay, 80 upon 11. Descend and maintain 2,000.
80 upon 11, descend and maintain 2,000 feet.